kill the animals. This is because I have learned nothing, and while I love my girlfriend, I still need to sleep on the couch. Love you, Headache Queen. Shoutouts to the hashtag TrueChat. We have $10 from Mr. 45. Keep up the great work, AGDQ. We have $100 from Orange Man 20. I can't donate during Mega Man block because of work, but I had to donate during the Mega Man run for the runners that have inspired me to learn running my favorite Mega Man game and hopefully going to a GDQ one day. And for a great cause, my donation goes to Winner's Choice. We have $25 from Mega Man X381 for everlasting peace. We have $100 from Funky Syntax, donating to see Kirby Tilt and Tumble played on a DDR mat. Remember, save the frames and kill the animals. We got $50 from Kona Riken. The last time Kirby Tilt and Tumble was run at a GDQ, I missed it due to work. Let's get that incentive met so we all can enjoy it. We have $15 from Anonymous. First time donating. Love a Mega Man and have a few Mega Man Pearlers myself. Save the frames and kill the animals. Speaking of kill the animals, it is still ahead. Actually, its lead is increasing the longer we go. It's ahead by over $3,500. So that's good news for all you kill the animals fan. And don't get me wrong, I've killed a few Yoshis in my day myself. But if you want the animals to be saved, make sure to get your donations in. We've got $10 from Namtab, donating again because that Bowser canvas looks ballin'. P.S. Save at least one animal. Why not all the animals? We've got $10 from Charles Bunny. Hey, speedrunners, such a hot event is the perfect remedy for the winter cold. Good luck and have fun. And, oh, put my money to saving the animals. $75 from Stray Confusion. He says, I donate to kill the animals every year, but I feel bad they're losing so badly this year. Save the animals. Yay, Stray Confusion. Thank you. We've got $75 from @netsop. Lost mom to cancer in 2011. Glad to see you supporting the cause. Shout out to event staff and volunteers. Thanks, Netsop. Got $10 from Vexon. Watching this amazing event for years. This is one of the most amazing events of every year, along with SGDQ. Thank you for all being a beacon of hope when times can be dark. We've got $10 from Tinged Tugboat. Have been looking forward to watching AGDQ with my newborn, only 18 days old, since before she was born. Here's to hoping she grows up in a world without cancer. Save the animals. Well, thank you, Tinge Tugboat. Probably raising a little gamer there. We've got $10 from Solveron. My community lost a great friend before New Year's Eve to cancer. This money may not be much, but I put it forth in hopes of stopping stories like this from having to be repeated. Thanks to for everyone who works hard to put this together. Save the lives, save the animals. Thanks, Solveron. We got $15 from Ursa Major. Tilt and tumble! Got $30 from Anonymous. First time donating, long time viewer. Thanks for putting on the stream every year. I'd just like to say thank you to everyone who's donating this year. We try to read as many donation comments as possible, especially in between games when we're setting up. But even if your donation comment doesn't get read, just know that we are receiving your donation and we appreciate it so much from everyone who's donating to such a great cause, the Prevent Cancer Foundation. We've got $25 from Tamamo no Mei. First time watching, super cool stuff. Shout out to my friend Kit. Let's see that tilt and tumble. Let's check on tilt and tumble. Let's see what's What's going on? We're up over 1,000 for Kirby Tilt and Tumble. It's gaining ground very quickly. I'm excited to see that run. I'm hoping it makes it. We've got $70 from Hat Wearing Gamer. Greetings, AGDQ from hot and humid Australia. Hype for AGDQ this year. Good luck to all the runners.
Hype?
I'm not sure if you're taunting us because it's so cold here, but we'll just take it how it is. We got $10 from J-Ro. Looking forward to watching Cool Kid do Quake. Oh, me too. We got $50 from The Algorithm. I lost my friend Sean to cancer a month ago, and I really wish he was still around to play XCOM with me. I'm excited for Kirby Tilt and Tumble. It was our second favorite game. Save the animals, especially dolphins. Got $20 from Bro Team. First time donating, just had to say I love the Mega Man run. Mad respect for Andy for not tossing in the towel. You'll always be a winner in my book. We got $5 from Kanagi. Watching this with Mo, it's always fun to watch GDQ. You guys are all idols. Keep it kawaii. All right, without any further ado, are you guys ready for some Super Mario Kart? All right, and with that, I will throw it over to the couch.
All right.
Hello, thank you, thank you.
So, they were supposed to do the countdown.
Oh, are you guys ready for a countdown? I thought you might want to introduce yourself or something.
Oh, I was going to do it later.
We'll count down now then, if I could get a little help from the audience. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Hello everyone, and welcome to Awesome Games Done Quick 2017. I'm Svenne.
And I'm Slippery Ninja.
And in here we have two of the best runners in the world of Super Mario Kart. Representing the United Kingdom is Sami Cetin over here. And then we have Karel van Juvenboden, the Netherlands, over here.
He's the godfather of Mario Kart.
Oh. Yeah, so one nice fact is that the first game in this series was released 25 years ago, so this year. So hopefully it's going to be like a celebration about the 25-year anniversary. And Sami, he's the founder of the Mario Kart community, pretty much. This goes back to 1998, pretty much when he created the ranking system back in the day.
And I believe they have a ranking board, yes?
Yeah, exactly. So if you go to www.mariocartplayers.com/SMK, you will find all the information you need when it comes to leaderboards and information how to speedrun it and
Mr.
stuff like
Zoom
that.
Thought right away.
And oh, yeah.
And I do believe they have rankings for not only this game, but all of the Mario Kart games.
Yeah. So the reason why they have the big guys is because they have the max speed. But going from zero to max speed, if you don't get this mini boost in the beginning, it's a fairly, I don't think you got it. But that's the reason why it's the max speed, obviously, and they are better than when you take the curbs. When you start jumping, they take it better and stuff. So, yeah. So as I was talking earlier, like Sami, who's in the suit, his nickname is the Godfather of Super Mario Kart because he created the community and back it's like 19 years ago. So that's why he has a suit today. Sami is also the world record holder of this circuit.
This course, yes?
Yes. He's also featured in the Guinness World Record for his times.
I believe his time is around 11 seconds for a lap for this course?
Yeah, it is.
Which is really fast. And there's a technique they use. You'll see them go off course every now and then called New Super Turbo?
Yeah.
So is that, did I get that?
Yeah, that's one. So when you see them going out on sand or whatever, like you can keep full speed like over a second there. So as you see, Sami did that. Really good.
So they start their turn just before they go out of bounds, and then they get a boost throughout the whole.
Yeah. So unlike last year, when they raced against the computers, this is fairly This is not RNG based at all, so it's all about skill. There's like three stages as RNG.
Yes.
There's gonna be a couple of fishes that spawns differently.
This course features a crazy
And this
jump
is this is a very famous forward. Jump here. Like that jump is frame perfect on this on this version. So
ordinarily you need a leaf to get across it, but if
yeah,
you do
exactly.
it very
so
frame perfect, you can
so
get
that's
over
why
it.
You're probably not gonna see it on Go For It. So yeah, it's
just
yeah, no one is gonna go for it. Hopefully. So if you get it, you save a second, but if you fail it, you lose like between 5 to 6 seconds.
That's huge.
Yeah. So it's going pretty good so far.
It's like risk versus reward kind of deal with that jump.
Yeah. So.
So both racers are opting to stay very safe.
Mm, indeed, indeed. So far so good. Like, I think Sam is ahead of it. Okay, he's not going to go for it. All right.
No. All right. I could completely ruin the race right away if
okay,
I do that.
Yeah.
It's just like...
Yeah, so we could just save time there, but we need to play safe.
And I believe Bowser and Donkey Kong have the highest max speed.
Yeah, they have the max speed.
With that, yes.
But they're slower in the acceleration, so that's why they need the mini boost here in the beginning.
Yeah, it's very crucial to keep that speed up. So
I don't think I got it, but it's fine. So on this stage, what the enemies is called the Twomp.
Yes.
They are 100% RNG.
And they
so
don't start until after the first lap.
Exactly,
so
exactly. So, and here they want to use like the manual jump instead of using those yellow bars, because that's actually faster than once chase. But so you're gonna see them using the right and left button to manually jump. But sometimes you can get, if you do it perfectly, you can get like a super jump and fall into the lava, and you don't want to do that.
Right.
Obviously.
Oh.
Yes. So if you bounce twice, you lose like all the momentum. But if you just hit the wall once, you don't lose the momentum. So you want to as much as possible try to avoid that.
And this is the most basic of the Bowser's Castle stages.
Yeah.
We'll see later on that they'll like use little speed turns.
Yeah.
And
so Karel has all the world records pretty much in these levels, like all the Bowser levels. So yeah, so hopefully he can catch up. So it's gonna be nice. Yeah, so Sami's playing really nice here, really tight.
Yeah.
So that's why you see them jumping when they're cutting the corners, because if you don't cut, if you don't jump, you have like a certain vicinity you can walk in, but you can
just
cut doing jumping
as close as possible, right?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Gain as much speed around as possible too.
Okay. Yes.
Wow.
So far, so good.
Yeah, about a 3 second difference there.
Mm.
Still very close.
Okay, so there is a trick you can do on this stage, but if you fail it, you pretty much have soft up the game, so they are not going to go for it. Okay, both got the super speed. You know, that's really good. Now, cutting quarters are really crucial for achieving like back speed, and these guys have been around for, like as I said, like 90 years, so it's pretty good. Like, and last year, if you watched, I don't know if you were here, but I was in this couch, and after all the contest tracks, they managed to be like 0.1 seconds from each other at the very end, so it was super hype. So hopefully it will happen.
Once again, using the new turbo boost.
Yeah. So there's not a difference because they're playing the Japanese version and the American version. And this speed-wise,
one of them is playing the Japanese version, one of them is playing
the so speed-wise, there's not a difference. But there's like a celebration scene at the very end if you beat a cup that was censored in Europe and in America. So that's the only reason why. That's the only difference. Yeah. So they're doing something that wasn't, you know, good for the European or the American levels.
Right.
Yeah, so that's a fun fact.
Breezing right through Mushroom Cap, heading into Fire Cup here.
Yeah, so like every single Mario game, they have mini turbos. That's why you see them like not losing speed when they do some stuff. Like it's not like in Mario 64, for example, you do left, right, left, or right, left, left to get a boost when you do corners. Here it's different.
Yeah.
Yeah,
they each have mini turbos, but the mechanics are slightly different in each version.
That's really nice. I've never seen
a really nice jump over that.
Yeah, he jumped over the wall there. I've never seen that before, to be honest. Super nice. So, I mean, when I played this game back in the day, I used to use the feather to do that. This is impressive for me. So, we have notes here.
Oh, you do, yeah.
All right. Yeah, so if you're interested in learning how to speed on this game, you should contact both Karel and Sami on Twitter, or you know, on the forums or whatever, or on
check
Twitch.
Out the website.
Yeah,
look at times.
Because every single year there's like a world champ. Man, he took. That's really nice. So every single year in August there is a world championships in France, and the French community is really large there.
Yeah.
So
the French community is huge for.
Yeah, and they don't only race this. They actually have like tournaments in battle mode as well. So it's really unique to see like, well, like when ordinary casual runners like me or you would play this, we don't have technique. We just find the red shells and just shoot at each other. Like, but you should see those those matches like back in the World Championships.
The
man,
stage
that's
just
amazing.
Has like really tight jumps.
Yeah.
Really tight jumps, really tight movement. If you clip one of those tiles, you lose a lot of momentum and a lot of time.
So
the accuracy has to be spot on.
Yeah. Man, it's very, very close. Ooh. So yeah, they don't want to hit the tiles because. Unlike the other tracks, you lose pretty much the momentum right away there. Mm-hmm. So you only get one shot. And you can actually fall down. That happens a lot. Okay.
You guys got a second apartment.
Oh, Donut Plains.
You have any notes for Donut Plains?
No. So there are moles here, and they're pretty random as well, but hopefully these guys won't get stuck by one. So yeah, there's a couple of enemies that's RNG in this game. It's the moles, it's the fishes, and it's the twomps in the Bowser Castle levels. So other than that, it should be all skill-based, pretty much. Which makes this more like impressive.
The moles jump straight up and down. So
this community is even older than the speedrunning community, because you know it's natural that if you have a timer, you start having starting leaderboards like back in the day, so it's really nice.
We've got a $20 anonymous donation. Mario Kart, my childhood.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I played something out of this game.
My childhood and my adult life.
The nostalgia story.
Yeah. Okay, so who do you think is pulling ahead at the moment? This looks like. Karel is in the lead.
It's a momentous race.
Yeah, so.
I'm pretty speechless, to say the least. I see these guys. I think I'm pretty decent at Mario Kart, and then every time I'm blown away.
I mean, for some reason, I always use Toad or like Yoshi here.
I don't know why.
Toad or Yoshi. They have
the max acceleration.
Yeah, they have Koopa as well.
Toad, Yoshi, and Koopa are higher acceleration, and then Mario and Luigi are kind of balanced.
Yeah.
And then the heavies here are max speed.
Yeah, look, when
not very good acceleration.
Like when I was a kid, I never picked these guys. The only reason you pick these guys is when you have battle mode and you can like hit each other. And then you lose.
In the later Mario Kart's character selection isn't as big of a deal, but it's more so the card you choose.
Yeah.
But here it's just cards.
Yeah, so hopefully they won't get hit by a thwomp here because this is one of the next. Okay, it gets. It's actually nice. Okay, don't fall down. Okay.
So the stuff that all comes down, cutting the corners as close as possible, yeah. Not getting hit by thwomps.
And they can, also, if you hold down the jump button, you can actually keep the momentum and the line of.
And in the mode they're racing, I believe there's no coins, which
coins
affect
no
speed
coins,
the GP.
No weapons, so it's all. This is like the creme a la creme when it comes to Mario Kart running.
It's just
like
raw racing.
Some people like to speed run, so to speak, the games, but when it comes to like good times, it's this, because there's no RNG, and so if you have a time that's like a split second better than other ones, you have put in the effort into the game. Yeah. There's no RNG involved at all.
Exactly.
So when it comes to Mario Kart running, that's like the most important part. Like, they take pride in every single stage. So they have like they have score for like first lap, and then they have for all three laps. So there's two different ways of counting points there. I mean points.
And in the time trial modes, the game keeps track of all of that. So sorry, what was I gonna say? It's very good.
We have a $350 donation from Oxenovo. I can't think of a better cause than fighting cancer. As for the fate of the animals, well, I'll leave that to you.
Thank you very much for that generous donation. So yeah, we are here to get money for the Prevent Cancer Foundation, which is doing an awesome job. Has done it for many, many years. So every single coin you can spare,
it's always amazing.
Like, I lost my grandmother and my babysitter back in the day when I was really young. So yeah, that's why I'm here, like trying to support as much as I can. So yeah, cancer is one of those diseases, you know, that's, and I don't want to talk about it. So yeah, it comes a lot of pain, and if you're a survivor, you're truly fortunate. But obviously, you can't save everyone. No. Hopefully, they can find a cure. And that's why we're doing this.
Do what we can.
Yeah.
Because we must.
We have $10 from Esquire Sandwich 26. Great Mega Man race. Can't wait to see a race of the best Mario Kart game. Money to Kirby Tilted Tumble.
So one new feature with this game is like, it's 3D, but it's not really 3D. It's done in mode 7. So the car is actually like stilt. It's just the map that goes right to left.
It's a bit of a mess.
Yo, it's really nice so far, guys. Keep it up. Yeah, so mode 7 was like a very special thing that was invented for the Super Nintendo to Francis, right?
Yeah, it's a special chip for...
Yeah. So for example, in this game, it's like the map just turns around and it has like a 3D... Like the mechanics are 3D, but the map is like 2.5 3D pretty much.
Yeah, it's 2.5D, so...
So yeah. In this stage, they are the fishes. Karel doesn't like this fish at all because they can spawn in very dangerous. Like, they spawn at different places and all.
Yeah, it's quite random.
Okay, come on, baby. Oh, Sami got it. Oh, Sami's back in the lead. Oh, yeah. So also the fishes doesn't stay at one point. They jump to right or left, so they can do a sneak attack on you and you're like.
The more like, stage.
Yeah, exactly.
The fish.
Yeah. The fishy fish. So yeah, and it's really nice that you jump over this water.
Wow. Very specific jumps over those waters.
Yeah, man, this is so hard. So I'm very impressed with this. Like, stuff like this blows your mind if you grew up with the games.
Yeah.
Oh, shocker.
Holy shit.
So we might see some fancy stuff here. So it's gonna be really nice.
And of course, the music is spot on.
Yeah. It's just, let's see.
It's so enjoyable to play this game.
Ooh, Sami's doing it. Yeah. So when you have this boost, you have approximately like 1.2 seconds before you lose the actual full speed. So sometimes, on the last lap, especially, if you have a long stretch that's actually faster, you try to use the boost plus the slowdown to get into the goal right away.
Right.
Instead of just, you know, doing the old-fashioned way, because you can save time at the very end. Because if you lose time when you reach the goal, it doesn't matter. But if you do it like during the actual run or during the actual lap, it's like, you don't want to do that.
breezing through this course. Amazing.
Ooh, yes.
That one was for you, Eric.
Oh, yeah. These stages, like, on the first lap, you want to break the blocks that's in your
lineup.
Yeah,
I knew
path,
it.
Pretty much. Oh, you didn't get it? Oh.
No.
Oh. Okay, it's going to be even now. Yeah, so that's, like, the worst thing. Like, if you don't get the mini boost in the beginning, like, you lose, like, a couple of seconds. But obviously, the backspeed will compensate.
So they hit
for
the
that.
Ice and then they jump
yeah, yeah.
to not
exactly.
lose momentum.
Exactly. So just on the first lap, you just break the ice that's in the away from the line of sight or whatever, like, the fastest way possible. So that's the technique to do. And obviously, you can avoid it, but yeah.
Uh oh.
Ooh. I don't like the sound of that. Ooh, it's so sweet.
Maybe we should have a higher time. This is a difficult course, so.
Yeah. Believe me, it's not easy.
I ended up in that water trap.
But when they explain how to do it, it seems like in their mind it's like perfectly easy.
Yeah.
Whoa! Man, it's.
Oh, let's go RNG.
All right. This is it.
This is it.
So they want to stay on the left path, except when they have like three options, they want to be in the middle one. That's actually the fastest one. And there's another twomp on that. So in this section, come up to the right here. They want to be in the middle one, like that. There's no twomp there, as you can see also. So it's faster and no, not as dangerous as that one.
Nothing
and now it's
down.
Constant fun. This is 100% RNG now, so.
Yeah.
If they're very unlucky, they can get hit by the guys, especially around here. Like this four in a row here, like here. Ooh. Oh,
this
nice sound, really nice.
Fall, right?
Yeah, Carl. Yeah, I'm not gonna say pronounce his last name because I don't want to offend the Dutch people. Whoa! Oh.
Wow.
Yeah, that was what I was talking about. Like,
wow.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, man.
As you mentioned, those twomps.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did not see that one coming.
I don't think anybody
yeah,
did.
It's brutal when it happens, dude. So, it would be a good time if you have some donations.
All right, I've got a $75 donation from Anonymous. Mario Kart is one of my favorite games. I missed the Zelda earlier, so I knew I had to donate while this was running. Put this towards the winner's choice.
Oh, yeah.
Got $121 from Deltorius. Hey there, AGDQ. First-time donor. Let's beat cancer together.
Yeah. Ooh, I had to slow down. You see, like, all four was down, so there was not a single way to get past that.
About that swamp,
nice.
Catch up is real too.
Yeah, so
that dodge.
Karel here got all the world records for the Bowser and Bowser level. So.
Unreal.
Okay, no one has chosen the like the wrong track so far, so it's nice. That's like the biggest mistake you can do. So yeah. So I'm really impressed with this. Like I play this so much as a kid. Yeah. So obviously we weren't like the dedicated commentators. They couldn't make it, so we had notes and stuff. So hopefully
we're the fill-in. So I hope we're doing
yeah,
okay.
Hopefully we would like to try out and help out our fellow speedrunners. So
I think you guys are doing a great job.
Thank you.
Yeah, me too.
I was literally told to do commentary for the first 10 minutes. I was like, all right. Maybe 15.
So yeah.
So this stage has a. This stage is the one with the jump, right?
No. Yeah, yeah. 999. It was the other one.
Yeah, that's later on. Okay.
So yeah, coming up is like. Yeah, there's so much to talk about. On certain stages, especially like the last one, the Rainbow Road, which is tradition.
Pretty straightforward stage. We can read another donation.
Yeah.
Sure. You we got $20 from Dax592. Really great to see the Super Mario Kart run. This game is still a favorite party game with my group of friends. Kill the animals.
Spoke like a true speedrunner.
who got $50 from Blobfish. Greetings from the coldest place on Earth, Michigan. $50 goes to bonus Kirby Tilt and Tumble.
All right.
Going into the final cut.
Now, yeah, he...
And donut planes.
Yeah, the malls can be a bit tricky here. And also, they're going to try to do an extended, like, slide during this bridge here. There's a hole in it, like that.
Ooh.
So it's really, really special. Ooh, they got a boat. Ooh. You see, that was close that he got them all there. But yeah, obviously these guys are the best in the world, and you should follow them. And if you want to...
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, sounds like I need to quiet
bit of trouble. Yeah.
Balls are always trouble.
So yeah.
Ay, 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 ay.
Oh.
No. The water is a huge slowdown in this part, so hopefully you can cover it.
Don't worry about it. Like, this is the last four stages are super hard. So we can gain time. But yeah, so if you want to learn this game, you should go into... MarioKartPlayers.com/
Oh, come
SMK.
On.
Ooh. Okay, yeah. So once again, on this stage, there's going to be very sneaky fishes here. Depending on the spawns,
yeah,
like, okay, that looks like a good spawn, to be honest. That fish is not in the way. Okay, this is actually really good for him. Let's see if Carol gets the same luck here.
This
yeah.
Fish looks so
oh, yeah. It's not even in sight.
And that guy, oh, okay, perfect. They got the same, yeah?
The fish looks so unassumingly menacing.
It can change, though.
Yeah. They just jump, they're like happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
they're just like happy to get in your way.
Yeah, coming up is like one of the most impressive speedruns when it comes to tracks. It's gonna be the next snow one. You're gonna see some amazing things that's gonna blow your mind. Especially like we two, like we obviously play the game, but they're gonna do stuff that's beyond this world, in my opinion, of course.
We've got a $10 donation from Anonymous. I will never forget how hard 150cc Special Cup was. It taught me how to rage quit as a kid.
Yeah, you are not alone, so there. We feel your pain.
I understand.
Ooh, goes well for you. Nice, nice. High point for that. Okay. Something over the hole. Ooh, yeah. Ooh.
Is that one of those we mentioned earlier? And
you're hitting one.
Just as mentioned before, just hitting the corner on any of these stages.
Yeah,
is just
especially
a
this.
Slowdown.
Like on the other tracks, if you just hit, like you had two hits, then you lose all the momentum. But this one, you lose. You know,
and especially for the characters that don't have a good acceleration.
Exactly.
But the top speed difference is definitely worth playing this game.
Yeah.
So.
Okay, got it. Man, man, it's so intense.
And the music only adds to that tension.
Yeah.
Just coming into the final lap here. The final, and of course, the most tricky ghost house in the game.
Yeah. I think the... Yeah. The next stage.
Oh, you did a 119.
Yeah.
Yeah, but this stage, this is the one that I was talking about earlier.
So
they're going to do...
Callings,
they're going to do, like... They're going to jump. You see the small islands on his map. They're going to
jump across those islands.
Yeah, yeah, they're going to do some.
My word.
Yeah. Like here. Back. Let's see. Man, it's so impressive. Like back in the day,
Oh, come on, man.
I'm so impressed. I'm forgetting to
so difficult.
Here.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, I'm so impressed with that gameplay. It's not.
I'm just gonna sit here and
yeah,
because I have like no words. This is amazing.
Ooh, he did it! He did it! Oh!
Wow!
Yeah, that's why you try it on the last one, because then. Come on, KVD, you can do this. Yeah, that looks good. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so the last stage is coming up, which is obviously like the traditional Rainbow Road. It's in every single Mario Kart game. And this one obviously has no rails, so.
But also electrified thwomps, which would take away your coins if you had coins.
Exactly, and they will stun you and
stun you, stop you, spin you around.
Yeah.
Make you disoriented.
It's Man, that sounds like a song.
I wasn't really trying for that, but yeah. Great.
It's really nice. Yeah, so unless Sami doesn't do a big big mistake, I think he has this on the bag.
Yep.
But yeah. They have really good times, so it's super impressive. Like, I'm beyond words when it comes to most of this.
I'm probably gonna go back home after GDQ week and sit down and play Mario Kart for a week.
Yes, solid gameplay for both runners. Yeah, this is probably the closest you can get to esports when it comes to speedrunning. There's no RNG involved, and everybody has like the same playing field.
The music speeds up in the last track and just increases the tension.
Yeah, for sure.
Unbelievable.
Indeed, yeah.
Great job, you guys.
Great job.
Finish strong here.
Yeah. Nice, really nice, guys. Man, so follow both players. And if you're interested in
they
are here always.
Thanks for coming, Terry, guys.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks for watching.
We did our best.
Great, man.
Happy luck.
All right, that was Super Mario Kart. Thanks so much to Sami Cetin and KVD for an excellent race. Brings back so many memories for me, I'm telling you what. Mostly of falling in the water on that ice level. All right, so this is Awesome Games Done Quick 2017. Thanks for tuning in. Coming up next, we have Quake. Any percent easy mode run by Cool Kid. You are not going to want to miss that. All right, guys, this is the end of my shift, so I'm going to throw it over to Lennon Free. This has been Yellow Killer Bee. Thanks for hanging out with me today, guys.